Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, La ilaha illallah, Akbar. Subhanallah, Alhamdulillah, La ilaha illallah, Akbar.
Whoa, okay, mashallah. So, okay, so who's ready? Who's ready? We're on a journey here. It's a journey of learning. It's a journey of hopefully inspiration. And I hope it's a journey more than anything of awareness. I'm so happy for you to be aware of what we're doing. I personally, I love what I do. I don't know if you guys picked that up, but okay? I love this stuff, man. Are you joking? I mean, for me right now, I'm in the zone. I got a board, I got a pen. Oh, Lord have mercy. I mean, really, you got to understand. But now, let's get serious and talk about something all of us love. We love something called Dawah. Yes?
Yes.
Yes or yes?
Yes.
Everybody who loves Dawah, raise your hand. I don't even want to see a hand down right now. You better, yes. No, I'll come over there. No, we love Dawah. So what is Dawah? We're inviting the creation back to the worship of the Creator. Simple. That's how I take it. And I understand that there's a formula. There's a three-part formula for Dawah, for it to be successful. Two parts are essential. The other one, we need to work on. Let me share that with you, and you tell me if you agree. Fair enough? So what is the key thing about Dawah? What is the key element that we have to do? Well, I put it down here. TTP. This is formula number one. Don't make any mistake. You have to TTP. If that doesn't work, you have to go immediately and directly to formula number two. TTMP. So, what is TTP? First formula of Dawah is talk to people. That's really difficult.
Exactly.
We have to talk to people. What do we talk to them about? Me, I've had a lot of people come in, people take shahada, oh, no problem. For me, I find out what's bothering them. I find out what it is they're stressed with the difficulties they've had to deal with, and how they've come now to put themselves in situations, or they're forced into situations they didn't want to be in. And once we find out what that is, we show them how Islam solved that problem. We're not talking to them. I'm not talking to them about Christianity and double thing and this and that, and you're a kafir this. No. When we're doing that, for me to do that, I'm ready to, when I get to that point, I'm making janazah on their dawah. Their dawah is finished with me. I used to be one of them. You can't talk to me like that. You can't talk about the three and one and one and three and, I mean, the math doesn't add up. That's one thing. On the other hand, they're breaking their own laws. If you look in the Bible, just to give an example, if you look in the Bible, you go to Exodus 20, verse number 1. This is where the people are coming now, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's talking to Moses, alayhi salam. And he's telling him what? He's telling him, I am the Lord thy God, who brought thee out of the land of Egypt, out of the house of bondage. Thou shalt not have any, bow down and worship any graven image. I am the Lord thy God, who brought thee out of the house of Egypt, out of the land of bondage. Thou shalt not worship any god before me. Thou shalt not bow down and worship any graven image that's in the heavens above, the earth below, and the water below the earth. For I, thy Lord, am a jealous God, and will visit with iniquities those who hate me to the third and fourth generation. So what does it say? You see, we examined that. I was in Qatar. When I was in Qatar, they invited me to go and do a Dawah program with some brothers training, like I'm doing here. And what they doing? They want to talk. I said, okay, let's talk. The person they're bringing me to talk, and the other people who are gathered that want to talk about this, they keep wanting to go to all the social issues. They don't talk about, the Muslim man, he can have three wives or four wives, and you got to do this, and you got to, it's okay, let's not talk about that. Let's get back to the issue of Tawheed. Because this is only talking about Tawheed. This is talking about the oneness of God. If we can't talk about that, there's no reason for us to talk. Let's have a coffee. Let's go ahead and talk. Let's talk about sports. They have a soccer thing coming up. Let's go talk about basketball. What do you need? Why are we talking? If we're not talking about Tawheed, we miss the point. We get into all these things where we want to do this Muslim dialogue. I disagree. I don't think we should be talking about it. Unless we're talking about Tawheed, I don't think we should be talking at all. Let's just be friends. Let's go for a coffee. Let's just get to know each other. Let me show you how I put Tawheed into my life and how Tawheed has changed my life. Worshipping one God with no partners has come now to make me a better human being. Let's have that conversation. If we're not talking like that, I think we're just wasting a lot of time. It looks good. It's very entertaining. Wallah, subhanAllah, it's entertaining. But really, we're wasting a lot of time. If the people aren't coming now, they want to talk about what's going on and all these social conditions and all this kind of thing. We didn't talk about Tawheed. The guy was going now, he was going now to steps. He was like 25, 26, 30 steps away from the one step that he's supposed to be focused on. Tawheed. That's in his book. Now, how do we explain that? You know, we came to him, he's saying that he believed, they still believe. He's studying around Islam, but he still wants to hold on to this thing of Jesus is one, but he's three, but he's three, but he's one. We say, but hold on. Okay, let's put aside that whole thing about who Jesus is, and let's just talk about his origin. Where did he come from? Everyone knows that Jesus came from where? He is the child of Mary. Is there anyone who disagrees? Not even the Jews disagree. Yahoo doesn't disagree. The Christians don't disagree. There is hardly anyone who's disagreeing. So everybody knows that his origin is that he's a child who came out of Mary. Yes?
Yes.
Okay. So let's break it down. Exodus 20, verse number 1 says what? Don't worship anything from the heavens, from the earth, from the water. Where'd Jesus come from? Was Mary from this earth? If Mary was from this earth, then that precludes him from being among those things who can be worshipped. End of story. Unless you're going to break, this is the first law of the Ten Commandments. If you break this law, all the rest of them doesn't matter, you keep them. Honoring your mother and your father, don't steal, don't do adultery, don't do this, doesn't matter. Why are we having all these long, drawn-out conversations, entertaining all this stuff? No, let's just talk about Tawheed. We talk about Tawheed till they submit. Otherwise, we leave it alone. I'm just telling you what my experience. My family, they want to talk about all the different things. They talk about things that are going over here. They see this, oh, you're joining with those people over there. Those people are crazy. Do you see what they did? They blew up this. They did like that. The damage here. I didn't talk about that. I didn't discuss that. I don't go reading newspapers. I don't even have a TV. I'm talking about Tawheed. And every time they want to get way over here, I bring them back over here. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about this. If you're not talking about this, what are we discussing? I don't entertain it. I think it's nonsense. It's great entertainment. Our community loves to be entertained. But if we're going to get serious about the Dawah, I mean, we got to get to the Tawheed. Because at the end of the day, we can talk about all the social issues. We could talk about the man having the four wives, and we could talk about how the Muslim is praying five times a day, and how he's fasting in the month of Ramadan. Oh, mashallah, all of those things. But all of those things are based on what? Tawheed. If they don't get that, why are we even discussing them? And if we engage in all of that discussion, what happens? That person who we're talking to, that person comes now, and they leave from us, and they get hit by a cookie truck. And they die. And they didn't die with Tawheed on their mind and coming from their lips. Can we be blameworthy for that? We talked about all the different things like this and all the entertainment things like that, and we didn't bring them back to the point? Assalamu alaikum. Take care. Thank you so much. Jazakallah khair. You see, anyway, I'm just saying, that's just me. That's just me. And again, I asked you before we start, okay, guys, are we going to talk straight or you want me to give you the fluff? I'm not good at fluff. I don't like it. I think it wastes a lot of time. The people who are coming out to want to hear me talk, from my family, even the people who hate me, when we get to the point we're talking about this, they don't get to leave from that point at all. Finish. You do not get to leave from the point of Tawheed. And if we want to take Tawheed, we can look at Tawheed from so many different angles. Somebody sneeze, watch with them. What'd you say? Yahamakallah. Well, no. You see, the thing is, I say Yahamakallah, what are we all supposed to say? Did you know that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created Adam, what was the first thing Adam did when he blew into him the ruh? He sneezed. What did he say? Alhamdulillah. Going back to what? Tawheed. Come on. We have Tawheed all around us. It's right there. And we're talking about what? Something down the road? Something that they can come now and they're saying, oh, but the Prophet, he married a girl, he's 9 years old. So what? What's that got to do with Tawheed? He did it based on Tawheed. How can we keep on spinning around and trying to make excuse? We don't need to make excuse. Not for Islam, not for the Prophet. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected him. And Allah will protect us, but we got to get back to Tawheed. So, there's two aspects that I consider formulas for dealing with Dawah. TTP, which means?
Talk
to people. And if that doesn't work, what are we supposed to do? Talk to more people. I'm sorry. No, because we did in the beginning, man. There's 2 billion over here and there's 5 billion over here. Does anybody see an opportunity here? I mean, you know, come on. Do the math. You see, the people, no matter how much we come now to not do our job, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already done the job. Can we present ourselves as people who want to be part of that process to invite the creation back to the worship of the Creator? It's not complicated for me. I'm a simple guy. I don't consider myself, you know, I was saying to Sheikh Abdulrahim McCarthy, we were talking, and I was saying, I hope the people understand who I am. Because again, they're coming out, big Sheikh, Sheikh. I said, guys, me, I'm the guy. You know when you go in the show, sometimes you go in the theater, and you come from outside and it's very light, and you go into the darkness, and the guy's walking, he's got the flashlight. He's blocking, you're walking with him because you can see, because he's holding the light. And I'm the guy who's holding the flashlight. And I'm bringing those people who want to come now to learn about Islam and about Tawheed to who? To guys like McCarthy, to Bilal Phillips. You see, when we start talking the true religion, we start talking about what Islam is. These are books, I had stacks of them. I gave them all away. I was in the hotel. I'm giving it to the people who are in management. I'm going in the street and the people are asking, do you have any book? So I'm giving them. I'm going to the Dawah Center and I'm giving them. Because I'm only inviting them to one thing. The oneness of Allah. If they're not ready to deal with that, why are we having any conversation? Let's drink some coffee, man. Let's talk about something else. They got the World Cup coming into the region. MashaAllah, that's going to be great. Why are we doing what? No, I think we take too much time for that thing. There's one other aspect of Dawah that I think is really needing and that we have to really be responsible for. We're trying to take responsibility. If you remember, I came here with Muhammad Robert Heft. Yeah? He's my brother. He's the one who he convinced me, and it wasn't hard. He said, brother, I love the work you do. And he's the guy who has been hiring me so many times in Canada to be able to work with the new Muslims who are coming in with so much baggage. They got drug problem, they've been abused, they've been raped, they've been in jail, there's so many things. And he said, can you talk with them, can you work with them? I'm working with them. And we're getting phenomenal results. He said, brother, you really, the people here, they're not going to support you. We're doing for 25 years, nobody helping us. We're going out of my own pocket all the time, all the time, all the time. I'm going to his pocket all the time, all the time. We're going to other people's pocket all the time. So look, let's just go a little bit further. Let us just keep a little bit more going. Let us just try. So he said, brother, if you come over here, maybe if you can get your paperwork in order, there are people here who will help you. To do what you know is a good thing to do, to help those people nobody wants to help. The people who are suffering in silence and have no way to reach a better condition. You help them, maybe these people help them. Okay, so we come. You see? One of the key things I see as being a major problem for us as Muslims, we're doing the Dawah, we're bringing people into Islam and they're carrying all their baggage. And the one thing that we're not doing, I don't think is worthy of who we are and what we should do, is we're not doing enough of this. Yep. Follow up. We are not doing a follow-up. The people come in, we give them some shahada, we give them the samosa, we give them a pat on the back, drink some chai, let's go get something to eat, and so on like that. The next day, they can't find anybody. How sad is that? I personally, and I'm not talking about you, I'm talking about me, I feel ashamed that we do that. But me, I'm not completely like that. I don't do a lot of that. I have guys who I give shahada to in the jail. I have one brother, man, if you see him, he's an amazing guy. I gave him shahada in 1996. He was a major gang leader, big player in the gangs, the whole thing on the scene. And he was one of those guys who the police were shooting at him, he was shooting right back. He was a bad boy. And we talk with him, we break him down. And I wish I brought my pictures and stuff like that. Because this guy here, he's still with us today. He's still one of my best friends like this. But I have hundreds of those guys who are like that. right? We have now, recently, last year we have in one of the jails, the federal jails, these guys are serving long sentences, sometimes life sentences. Those guys are in there, and we have one of the guys who's the leader of the neo-Nazi group. The neo-Nazis, you know, KKK?
Yeah.
Ku Klux Klan, all this kind of thing, and northern groups and all this kind of stuff. They're haters. They hate whites. I mean, they love whites and they hate everybody else. And I mean, they're adamant about this. We gave shahada to this guy, and we kept on giving information. He started realizing. He comes now to embrace Islam. He took his shahada. He's got 10 guys with him. 10. And they're all bad guys, and big white guys with the tattoos and the whole thing like that. You see them, they're scary. Well, I hope I can bring them here so you can see by yourself. When you see them, they're scary guys. If you see them on the street, you'll be like, holding your wallet. I mean, you got your kids with you? Come on, y'all. you want to get out from there, man. You don't want to be anywhere around these guys. Six of those guys, him and five other guys, they took shahada to. The other five, they said, we're not interested. How many times you heard that? Never. Even our community, they don't want us to even talk about it. But it's true. I can't come here and lie to you about something like that. That's just wrong. You see? So this follow-up, when these guys come out from jail, who you think they're coming to see? Me. I have a brother. His name Muhammad. Wallah. His name. He took the name Muhammad, but he did 17 years in jail. 17. He did every day of 17. He never took any parole. He's coming now to be among the people who are from, he's from Taiwan, and he was working for Chinese mafia in Toronto. And he was a shot caller. He had actually designated a number of people to get hit, shot, dead. And the guy who went and did it got caught, and they gave him up. And they charged him, and they convicted him, and he spent 17. When he was in jail, he now became Muslim. Who gave him shahada? Me. I'm giving him shahada, right? He's a very, very bad guy. He's a very great martial artist, and he's very vicious in his ability to strike and to just be aggressive. This guy became like a pussycat. He did 17 years. He gets out, who's the first person he calls? He calls me. So, Brother Ibrahim, thank you so much. I want to thank you for showing me about Islam and so on like that. What can I do to help you? Well, now he's still got to go through the process of being reintegrated back into our society. He doesn't know where to go. Our community has put nothing aside to be able to deal with him and people like him. How do we deal with that? Is he a good guy? He's a much better guy now than he was before. He had to leave all of that behind, but it was under the threat of death. And we had to speak on his behalf. If I tell you about the Jamaican guys who are part of the Jamaican posse, these guys are gangsters. If I tell you about the guys who are coming out to be from the Hispanic gangs, those guys are serious. We've given dawah to all of them, those guys are coming into Islam. When they're coming out from jail, we have no place for them. We do a great deal of this, but we have no funds. We have no place. So, Muhammad Robert Heft, my brother, and yours too, he allowed us to go and use his center to be able to come to have some events and to put on some training and to do some stuff at his center to be able to do that until we get our own. And my objective before I leave from this world is to get our own center, to have a place when those people come out that they have a place to go, that they can get the support and they can get the conditions that they need to be able to move their life in a good direction. Ask me why. I dare you. Why? You see, here's what happens. I don't know about here, but in Canada, if a Muslim does anything bad, it's on all of us. It's not him, not you. it's not the guy who did it who gets the blame. No, he gets the blame, and you see what they taught him? They went to madrasa. My God, man, look what they did in the masjid. They had a walima. I'm sure they taught this at the walima. And if you had to eat dinner, I bet they taught it there too. Come on. So we're taking all that heat? For what? For not helping people? who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has guided to Islam, it'd be like you not helping me. You think I did a good job? Am I doing a good thing? I'm doing some good stuff here? Yeah. Well, they have contributions to make too. They're ready. They don't know where to go. I'm saying, don't worry. Come, we'll find a way. We'll find a way together. You see, as I'm saying to you today, let's find a way together. You see, we want to be here where we're learning and we're earning, and not here where we just blame each other all the time and putting ourselves in that condition. This destroys us. You see, so this brings me to my presentation. Because again, I hope that you will understand there's a flow here. How we go from me to we. We got to get there. And this is not maybe. I'm not talking hypothetical here. I'm not talking theoretical. I'm telling you, we got to get there. And we get there together, or you can try by yourself. But if you're doing by yourself, then you're only doing what? Me. Does that work? Is there anybody who can achieve high achievements, significance, in anything they're doing by themselves? Is it possible? No. And if it's not possible, then what are we doing? How we're not coming now to make an effort, to make a commitment, to be able to move things forward, especially for the lowest people. Now maybe, okay, these people are far away from you, you don't know them, you don't understand them. MashaAllah, I get it. Okay? I'm here today. I'm representing them. Let me show you what we're doing. Yeah, we'll be my. You ready?
Yep.
Okay, so hold on before we go. So, who am I? Do you know who I am? Let me ask you that question. This is a good question. Do you know who I am?
Yes.
Hmm? Who am I?
You're a nice guy.
Brother.
You're a good guy, handsome.
Alhamdulillah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. No, keep talking. Keep talking. MashaAllah. No. I like your attitude, man. Yeah, go ahead, bro. No, you go ahead, man. No. Listen, all you guys be quiet, please. Fadda, yes, sir.
you have good experience about Islam. And you will, inshallah, benefit us about your experience, and that will be, inshallah, to come to your weight of good deeds.
Yes.
In Allah.
Inshallah. Inshallah. No.
And you will be.
Keep talking. This is
the best example. Inshallah. The best example for Dawah.
Amen. Here's what I say. May Allah make me better than what you think of me, yes. And may Allah help us with what we struggle with. Ameen. Now, understand this. Okay? First of all, I tell you the word welcome. Welcome. Mahabba. Huh? Welcome. Why do I say welcome? In the English language, welcome is one of the most powerful words. Do you know why? When you say it to somebody, you know what they feel? Welcome. See? Welcome. Just welcome. Be at ease. Take it easy. Just listen, open your heart, open your mind. Just be right here in this moment and let's take this journey. Just welcome. It's a simple thing. Yes. But we have to make people feel it. You know? You guys almost made me cry today. I feel so welcome. Really. You know, I go some places in my country, man, they can't wait for me to get out the room. Oh man, you're talking about all that criminal stuff. You're talking about this and no, but come on. Help the people. But anyway, this is my way I help the people. You should know. So this is my company, SIBKIS Counseling Services. We also have a nonprofit organization called SIBKIS Empowerment Services, under which we're striving to get funding to be able to put this together. It has the same training. Okay? I am SIBKIS Chief Inspirational Officer. See, nobody got that title. Yeah? See what I'm saying? Right? Yeah. No, I'm just saying, right? I'm just saying, I picked that myself. Actually, they gave it to me many years ago. Because they were inspired by what we do. They're loving it. They're saying, SubhanAllah, how do you get to the point where you can do so much with so little for so many for so long? You know why? You know how? Why? Tawakkal on Allah, wa la hawla wa la quwwata illa billah. Just so you know. Just so you know. It's a formula. Okay? So, Bismillah. Okay, so let's go for it. And I'm going to go kind of a little bit quickly. Actually, we can skip this. Yep. Okay, important note. I want everybody here to understand that when you go to class, okay, you go to a class, and the teacher is going to give you all kinds of different papers and tests and all this kind of thing, and at the end of it, the teacher is going to mark you an A, a B, a C, or D, or whatever. Every student here right now gets an A. Yes. You get an A. You get an A to start. Hey, how's that make you feel? Come on, hey, fellas, come on, man. You gotta. The brother, I've been waiting all my life to get an A, man. I have B's and C's. Come on, you get an A. Voila, I give you. I'm the teacher. I'm your coach. I'm your mentor. I give you A. Voila. Voila. You see, even he likes. He's like, oh, okay. I'm gonna raise my hand up next time. Oh no no. MashaAllah. Okay, so everybody gets an A. Everybody starts this presentation with an A. Okay? Congratulations. Now, what you do with your A, you see, I put this up here for a particular reason. And what is the reason? Is that so you could understand that we have a situation where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we come into this life and Allah gives us an A. What is the A? The A is Islam. He gives us the way to succeed. If you had pure A's on your report card, if you had all A's on the thing, nobody's thinking they're going to fail. But getting the A sometimes is very challenging, difficult. You have to do everything perfectly right. Who got Islam perfectly right for Allah to give it to them? Anybody? Huh? No. Even some of them, they had issues. They had issues. They went through different things where Allah had to teach them about the manners and akhlaq and the different ways to go ahead. What about Musa and Khidr? Musa said, I know everything, man. I'm the wisest man in the world. And Allah said, oh, not exactly. He sent him to Khidr. What did Khidr do, man? He killed he went and he smashed the boy. Why you do that? He went and killed the boys. Oh my God, man. You're killing people? Why? He said, no, you know what? You can't bear with me. You can't take it. He goes now to the place where they're telling him, oh, we need a place to stay for the night. No, you can't stay here. Get lost. He goes now and he's putting up the wall. He said, what are you doing, man? He said, okay, this is a parting between me and you. You can't be with me. So what are you talking? There's Allah teaching him. So he got it perfect? No.
No.
And this one, he got an A. Maybe no, he got a B. Yeah. He came better after that, but still. So my point here is this, is that we all have to come now to recognize that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as Muslims, he gave us the A. He gave us the Tawheed. Okay. You see the video. I'm asking the guys three questions. What are the questions? Manhood or book? What's the answer?
Allah.
Mahudinuk.
Islam.
Man Nabiuk. Come on. Listen. I mean, this is not rocket science. This is reality. When we get to the grave, what do the angels, they come and do?
Yes.
They're asking us these questions. Is it for only the Muslims or is everybody?
Everybody.
It's everybody. If you answer correctly, like we did, then you get a different condition. If you answer wrong, you get a different condition. So starting with an A, absolutely essential. Why? Because we want to focus people, we want to help people focus on how to be successful. I wasn't going to present it today, but I'm going to do something quickly after we finish this, okay? So let me go for it. So everybody gets an A, congratulations. Next slide. Okay. Blah, 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 blah. Okay, you want to hear about all of this? These are some of the things and all this kind of stuff. Entrepreneur, chaplain, prison chaplain, drug rehab counselor, violence reduction, leading authority on personal empowerment, gang reduction services. You know, the thing is, you know, I'll tell you, there's people in the government in Canada, in Ontario and so on like that. They offer me jobs, eh? They offer me jobs. They offer me good money. 50,000, 60,000, you know, like this, with benefits and all this kind of thing. Vacation, nice. Okay, but in order for me to take the job, I had to be willing to accept to be multi-faith chaplain. Multi-faith. You understand that? Anybody get that? So when the Christians are having Christmas, I have to help them. And I don't just mean help them. I have to go and help them set up the kufr and shirk. When the people are celebrating Dawah is it called? Dawah? They're doing like that? I have to be the one to help them? We have people in Canada who are called Wiccan. Anybody know Wiccan?
Yeah,
Wiccan. They're devil worshippers. Yeah. They're in the jail. And when they're coming out to come, I have to help them? Listen, are you joking? Are you freaking joking? Me? Me? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided me? And you want me to come and make kufr and shirk and help these people do kufr and shirk? And I'm going to take a paycheck? Nah, I don't think so. I pass. So is it difficult? Absolutely. Is it worth it? More than you imagine. I ain't selling out. I don't care. It's not about that. It's not about that. So I can give you a whole accolades of all this kind of stuff. I did many good things. Business, we did good in so many different things, blah, blah, blah. Next slide. Because it's documented. I'm saying to you these things because it's documented. Ta-da! What does that say? Who's that? Who's that handsome guy over there?
Exactly.
Hey, you see? Who's that handsome guy? What does that say? You know, the thing is, I went to a dinner, and I didn't know they were doing this. That they tell me, they call my name, oh, Imam Ibrahim Downey. Can you come? And they gave me this thing. There's nobody in there. When they gave me this, 2010, there was not one Muslim who had been with the program. I started in 1988. There's not one Muslim who kept their commitment and stayed with the program and dealt with this thing from that time until this time. They say, we're so honored to have you, and you've done so much for so many, for so long, with so little. We get to give you this as a small token of our appreciation. Ta-da! That time it was 18 years. That's 2010. Where are we now?
17.
How many years is that?
Seven.
So that's 25 years. They're recognizing. We started before that. We started before that. This is just one institution. The brothers are asking me, by the end of February, will you come back? They want me to go to the federal jail. They said, please come back. We have some programs. We need you to come. We do so many good things, if you understand. For me, I'm just kind of quiet and humble about it. I'm not making a big deal. But I love what I do. And I love helping people get the good result. And inspiring them to come what? To do what? To come back to the worship of Allah. Next slide. See, here's the thing, and this is one of our flyers. It's a real flyer. My number's on there, cell, office, and so on like that. So what is it? When they're born, they fill us with such hope. Sometimes things can go wrong as they grow, right? As parents, one of the best gifts that we can give our children is the ability to make proper decisions in life. SIBKIS success story, right? Learn how parents who had given up on their children found hope through our family and counseling strategies. How important is that? Are you joking? I mean, there's people who give up and say, man, I can't deal with him. I can't deal with her. I don't know what to say. I don't know what to do. And then we give them this. We share with them that. And they start to see there's possibility. And then we take the kids on the social awareness tour. And they open up. Okay, go, please. Next. Okay, so what do you see? Quick answer.
Teach and learn.
Teach and learn. Do you see the learn?
Yeah.
No, no. Look here. You see? Teach. T-E-A-C-H. Learn. L-E-A-R-N. Learning and teaching are the same. And I'm talking to you because we're talking about Dawah, but we're also talking about going from me to we. You see? And it's reflection. If you look at me, you can see we. And if you look at we can see me. Okay? So what is this? You see? Which one do we do first?
Teach. Learn.
Ah, well, I like your attitude, man. Yeah. We teach? Yeah. What are we going to teach? Exactly what are we going to... Yeah. I'm teaching you, but you're learning. So, okay, I teach, you learn, we learn, we teach. But no, what you're saying is not wrong.
Yeah.
Effectively. Really what it is we have to learn and then teach. And then when we're teaching, we're supposed to learn from the people we're teaching. And then be able to teach from that perspective. And they'll be able to learn and go back and forth. And this whole thing like this is supposed to be simultaneous. We have to keep it going like this. When we do that, changes everything on the spot. But we have to know that that's what we have to do. That this formula has to be in place. Next slide, please. The purpose of this training is to inspire you. Yeah. Okay, so next slide. Now we got past all of that, okay? So... Baby, I love this stuff. I'm sorry. You see that little dot on there? Whoa, easy now, easy. Okay, go. Okay, go slowly. He's getting so excited. Hold on. Okay, now, this dot. Don't make any mistake. There's a dot there. Where's the dot? Put the dot there, man. You're making me look crazy, man. I said there was a dot. There's no dot. Ubin, you did that to embarrass me, man. I'm watching you, boy. Come on now. So, this dot, consider this. Before I came and we started this program, and I'm just using this as an example. This was your level of understanding about what we do with SIBKIS counseling, what Ibrahim Downey is about. Let's be honest.
Yeah.
You say, oh man, mashallah, he came by plane, he must know something. He flew in, so he's got to know something. I mean, you don't just fly people in and they don't know anything. I mean, he's got to know something. So this is your knowledge about me, about what we do, how we do it. Huh? Has it increased?
Yes.
Has it increased? Next. Like this?
Yeah.
Okay, so now let's take this. You see? Let's take Dawah. We're talking about Dawah. Is there only one way to do Dawah?
No.
How many ways you can do Dawah?
Many.
How about Prophet Noah, alayhi salam? He did Dawah what? 950 years. He did it in the daytime. He did it in the night. He did it in the open. He did it in private. He did it every which way you could possibly conceive for 950 years. And he had a small group of people would follow him. Small. When they got on the boat wasn't full. There was room for more, but guess what? Some people just wouldn't take the ride. Okay? But it was about this awareness. They were all aware that something was going to happen. Did they accept that? No. Okay? But for the ones who did, guess what? Their awareness did them what? It made them more what? Can you go again? Oh, that's okay. Go ahead. Sorry. What are you doing here? Freaking me out here. Take it easy. Okay, we're good there. We're good.
You can click.
Yeah.
No, it's not working on click.
Ah, okay. So here we are, right? So again, this is about awareness. And we have to increase and we have to expand our awareness about the different methods, the different ways, and the different approaches to be able to get it done. For our program, for SIBKIS, we don't put this thing in front of ourselves like this to block it out. You know, if everybody's saying, oh, you can only do it according to the things that we agree from our culture and so on like that, we're not going to get anywhere. We're not going to get through to the kids. They weren't listening to you when they were in the house. How are they going to listen to you now they're in the streets? Let's not joke. So we have to increase this circumstance of awareness. Please. Okay, is that enough? Who thinks that's enough? I guarantee you that's not enough. The awareness that we need to have in terms of Dawah and in terms of coming out to be empowered and in terms of the circumstance of coming out to come together and go from me to we has to be off the charts. Like this. I'm telling you, I'm not an expert at this. I'm just telling you that we have a situation where we've done it with a number of people and we're trying to do it with more. We're trying to get people to be more aware of what they can do, how they can do it, and how to make it work. Fair enough? Okay, next. Okay, so. Okay, living above the line. I think we're going to skip this because you guys already seen this. Anybody know this? Anybody wasn't here? Are we doing this? No? Nobody? Everybody was here? You weren't here? Did you see this? What is that? Okay, so where do you want to position yourself for your future? You want to learn? Okay, so we check that off like here. Okay, we put the date, we put the time, we put the place, then we put our DNA stamp. Okay. Yeah, don't worry. Anyway, the whole point is, okay, you guys know this story. You know, I'll tell you, wallah, ya shabab, if you don't remember anything else I said, anything, if you forget every aspect of everything I taught you and I shared with you here, if you remember this, this will serve you unbelievably well. Unbelievably well. If you see somebody who's coming now to a point where they're acting confused and so on, just ask them, where do you want to live? Where do you want to live for the rest of your life? Not where you're at right now. What about the rest of it? What about the next decision you make? You know, we have people who are coming out to be in jail. They have so much crime, so much violence, so much bad things behind them. We say, listen, Allah's not concerned, overly concerned about what you did. He wants to know what you're going to do next. He wants to know, can you make tawbah? He wants to know if you can cover your bad deed with a good deed. If you can correct yourself. If you can do that, Allah is wide open. He wants to give you His mercy. He's a Rahman. What's wrong with you? You don't like it? Okay. You don't like it. But you have to be willing to learn so you can earn that mercy. And the learning is key. You have to. But you don't have to. We can't force you. But if you really want to take a value for yourself, you should. Okay. Next slide, please, sir. Okay? Actually, go two slides. We're going to go here. Yeah. Okay, you get the lesson, right? You see that? Okay, good. Okay. Now, okay, hold on. Go back. This is good.
All right.
No. Okay. No, one forward. Forward it. Yes. You see? Here's what we're dealing with. Oh, man, I love this. Oh, baby. Oh, man. This is it, baby. This is it. You see, these are who we're dealing with. These are the personalities. These are the character traits. These are the individuals that we're dealing with. When we start talking about dawah, this is what we're dealing with. People are going through all of this. And we're thinking, no, I'm going to give you some dawah. I'm going to tell you, you're going to straight path. We're talking. The people are going through this. And we're thinking, no, you should just come in Islam, and Islam is good for you. You don't have to go to hell. But the people have issues. They're struggling. And the thing is, they don't know what to do. They don't know how to overcome their things. We found from our training, people calling me doctor and all this kind of thing, because we deal with a lot of the circumstances of psychology. Right? What we found is that the human being has ability to have something in here, and when they have iman, their hearts can be full. Their lives can be full. So much good can happen to them. Like this. What happens when they come now to suppress or dismiss their iman? I give you a small example. The emptiness, it's empty. There's nothing to fill it. And what they do is they go through their life trying to fill it with whatever they think is going to work. And it doesn't work. But they keep on believing something else down the road. It's going to work down here. It's going to go over there. Never. Until you come back to that circumstance of filling it with what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given you in taqwa, you can never, ever fill it. It won't happen. Are you with me?
Yes.
Can I show you something? I know maybe I'm going off a little bit in some... I don't want to... Okay, forget about that. I don't want to come now to say to you this thing. Except to show you how we came to understand it and deal with it. Okay? This is called the SIBKIS Personal Success Triangle. What's it called? SIBKIS Personal Success Triangle. Personal Success Triangle. Okay. So what we have is, we have on the outside, we have three things. IC, which stands for internal communication. Internal communication, who are you talking to?
Yourself.
You're talking to yourself. Not talking to anyone else. And the internal communication, or the external communication, which is EC, it can either be positive or it can be negative. Are you guys with me?
Yes.
Okay, so here's the thing. We have a thing over here. You see, this is called external communication, EC. Now you're talking to somebody and they're talking to you. It's 50-50. Right? 50-50. But it can be 60-40. Because if the person is talking to you has authority, they're telling you what to do. But what if they're saying bad things to you? What if they're saying you're stupid? Or you're ugly? Or you're stupid and you're ugly? How does that make you feel? You see? It has an effect.
Yes.
And that effect is not good. It's negative. You see? So what happens to that? Then it comes down to you and what you do with that. You can't stop them from saying or doing what they're doing. But you can deal with it internally, which is internal communication. We call that process technical know-how. How you deal with it, either positive or negative. I'll give you my example. Our community back in Canada, shame on them, on some of them, and may Allah bless the ones who do help, right? But here's the thing. We're doing this program. We have this amazing training. We're doing all this stuff. They won't help. Okay? So what's my situation? They're coming out to be very negative with me. I mean, they're holding back from giving me the opportunity to go and do something all of us need anyway, and can be a model for everybody around the world. At a time when Muslims really need to be showing themselves how we can practice Islam and benefit people. Right? You guys with me, right? So their stuff to me is negative. And I'm not saying it to put them down. I'm just telling the truth. I just want to be clear. To me, it's negative. For me, I could choose to be negative or I could choose to be positive. That is the technical know-how. You see, I start thinking about how grateful I am about the situation that Allah has given me the guidance to come to Islam. So you putting me down, please, are you joking? Save your breath. You don't want to help? Get out the way, man. I'm not looking for you. I'm looking for the guy who's ready to help. You don't want to participate? Okay, this is not for you. I only want people who want to do this now. We don't need this whole room full up of people. We need the people who want them. Somebody asked me, brother, you know, there might not be a whole lot of people there. We might only get a few people. And so I said, listen, I don't want to hear it. I want to deal with quality, not quantity. If we could have this whole room full and everybody's going to be playing and jumping around and carrying on, and nobody's going to be paying attention, nobody's going to take this lesson, I'm going to leave here feeling unfulfilled that I didn't deliver as much as I could. To me, that's wrong. So, internal communication, external communication, technical know-how. Let's go inside and see what we can find in here. You know, one of the key things that give a lot of people trouble is a thing called fear. There's another thing too, where people go too far with a thing called love. And there's one thing that comes now to actually kill the soul, kill the spirit of the soul because of a thing called hope. I'm glad you guys are writing notes. Take pictures, whatever it is. This stuff here, it belongs to me. We developed this. We put this together. It's based on the circumstance of what we should do to be able to help people understand about how to go give dawah and how to do what we can to help people progress as human beings. So let me show you how we put that together. You see, we have fear. Fear is a big deal. Anybody here have fear? Of course we do. Yeah. So does anybody here know about love? You see, but when we start talking about love, love can be either good or it can be bad. Love isn't always good. Isn't not that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tell us in the Quran that, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said a hadith that it may be that you love something that's bad for you and maybe that you hate something that's good for you?
It's in the Quran.
It's in the Quran. Okay. So Allah knows. Yes. Allah knows and you don't know. You see? So this love thing, we got to balance it up. You see, one of the things that happens too is that people don't have this or people, anybody here got hope? I mean, besides me. Yes. And I'm talking to you guys in the back. Anybody here got hope? Yeah, okay, yeah, a little bit. That's okay. We're going to show you how to increase that. We will show you. I will show you. Voila. Will you listen? Okay. Okay, good. I just want to make sure. Now, you look like you're going to sleep, okay? I know you just want the pizza. We'll give you 10 minutes. We'll get pizza. Don't worry. You see, okay, so let me share with you something. I want to share with you something. Something very, very nice for me. You see this fear? Fear is not difficult to deal with. Let me show you how we help people with that. Right? Fear, you got to put things in perspective. So what is fear? Okay? Fear is something like this. Right? You deal with it very nicely when you understand that fear is false education appears real. False education appears real. False. You want me to write it out? False education appears real. So if something is false, do you have to fear it? Anybody? Do you have to fear it? It's false. You have to, why? No, why would you fear it? It's false. It's not right. It's not true. Why would you fear it? But you see, if you let it go here or you let it go here, then you let the fear overcome you. You let it come now to have an effect. So how do you get past it? How do you do that? I'll show you. Okay. False education appears real. Okay, I'm going to walk you through this. I'm going to continue with this, but I want to walk you through something else. You see this? I want a question here. Who here wants to win? Anybody besides me? I'm in it to win it. That's it. Okay? No Quran and Sunnah, no intercessors. Okay? Okay, when you decide you want to win, here's what you have to decide. What's important now? What's important now? You write it like this, and you populate it out horizontally. Write it vertically, populate it horizontally. What's important now? You can win at whatever you want, but you can't win all at the same time. You can't. But you can choose one thing, and if you put the proper elements together and all the different energy you need into that, your chances of winning become excellent. But there's something going to come. As soon as you decide that you want to win, something's going to come in your way. What's that thing? Fear. See, you're not going to have all the answers as soon as you decide to win. There's going to be a bunch of stuff that you're not going to know. You're not even going to know if you're going to be able to finish. Anybody here gone to school? Anybody? I mean, besides me? So, when you went to school, now, okay, everybody is okay, a very educated crowd. That's good. Right? So, when you went to school, anybody going to college and university, when you went to school, what happened? When you start school, they dump all this information on you. Did you ever feel like you're not going to make it? Come on. Be honest. How many times? I mean, you're stressed, man, and you got to do this homework, and you're pulling an all-nighter, and you got to test the next day, and you know, and all of this stuff is happening. So what's happening, right? You're thinking to yourself, "Oh man, I may not make it. You may not make it." So what is that? That's fear. You see, but you overcame it, and when you got to the thing, man, you're what? Dun, 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 dun. You know, come on. You're what? I always knew I'd make it. I always knew I had it in me. Oh yeah. Yes. Yeah, oh, the end. No, it's the beginning, right? But fear came, and fear came now. But fear is simple to deal with if you put it in perspective. False education appears real. It's not real. But in order to get past fear effectively, quickly, to be able to gain momentum, you have to do this. You got to focus. And what is focus? If I say to you focus, brother, what do you mean by, what do I say focus? What does it mean to you?
Concentrate.
Work hard.
Consistent.
Consistent. What else?
Attention.
Dedication.
Keep an eye on the goal.
Keep an eye, eyes on the prize. Absolutely. Yes.
Patience.
Yes. You see? Laser beam. How about that? You see? Like this. So we're talking about doing what? We're talking about life, but we're talking about dawah. So the two things can fit in the same place. The people who are doing the dawah have a life. The life itself is in the dawah, but the dawah is in the life. You see, for me, I don't go out and do dawah. I do dawah when I go out. Go out and do dawah. Don't just go out and, I mean, you can go out and do dawah, but just do dawah when you go out. You know the best dawah that I've seen? Good character. And the good, best character, who has the best character? Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Finish. So we should study him. Please.
He said the best of you will have the best character.
Okay, good. So when somebody comes now to mess up, what do we do? You see, they get to the point where they have this condition of fear coming to them. And because of the fear, they do make some mistake. Or maybe they have love and they make some mistake. Well, what is love? Love, okay, I'm not even going to put it here, but love is this. Will you listen? Listen, number one, you listen. When you have love, you listen. Huh? Oh, you overlook. V, you value. When you have love, you overlook. You value. And you do what? You encourage. You encourage. Huh?
Again?
Yes. Okay, yes. Love. L-O-V-E. Will you listen, you overlook, you value, and you encourage. Ya humakallah. I love that. See, Benny Adam. Yes. Okay, you guys with me?
Yes.
Yes? Okay, are you getting some benefit from here? We can just go home, man. Okay, I'm out. You see, no, we're not done. You can't leave. Block the door. Where's Mubin? Block the door. No, so let's talk about this. You see, I want to get to your stuff. Because you say you had hope. I would say, yeah, you say you have a little bit. Well, you know, if you have it, my question to you, or to all of us, is this. Is it okay for us to have hope? And who do we have hope in?
Allah
subhanahu wa ta'ala. You say you have a little. I say it's not like that. I say you probably have more. You're just being shy a little bit. You know, you have a lot more than you want to talk about. But if we have hope, is it okay for us to keep it by ourselves?
No.
Is it okay? You sure? What are we supposed to do with it?
Share it.
Huh?
Action.
Yes. How? What kind of actions? Let me show you. If we have hope. Remember, there's a formula here for success. What is the success? We want to win. What's important now? What's important now? Islam, dawah. Okay? What do we have to overcome? Our fear. Our fear of what? Our fear of speaking to people. Our fear of not having enough books. Our fear of being out in the sun. Our fear of what? The people not accepting. Doesn't matter. We have to overcome it by understanding it's false. In order to understand it, we got to get to what? Where we focus. Follow one course until successful. Do you get that? Follow one course until successful. Brother, what's the course? Ya Muhammad.
Club.
Huh?
The club.
Yes, mashallah. You see, that's why I give you the A, man. I knew you would deal with it, man. Nice job, brother. What is the course? Surat al-Mustaqim. Is there anybody have any doubt about that? Is, huh? A straight path. Follow one course. Subhanallah. Ihdina sirata mustaqim. We're asking Allah every day, 17 times. Sirat al-ladina an'amta alayhim. Come on. This is so simple. But guess what? We have to remember that the focus is the key. Because it gets us to the other side of the fear. And it gives us a circumstance of hope. The hope is an amazing element. It's the best thing that we could have. We can't keep it to ourselves. We have to help other people excel. Help other people be their best. It's not about us anymore. It's not allowed for us to keep it by ourselves and hold it back from them. It'd be like we had a cure for cancer, or a cure for diabetes, or we had some other kind of cure that for the people who had some sickness, and we have it and we don't give it. It's like the Prophet ﷺ being in the cave at Hira, where he's there and the angel Jibril is coming and grabbing him, squeezing him. Iqra' bismi rabbika alladhi khalaq. He said, no, I can't read, I won't read. He doesn't know how to read. Come on. So now he's getting the cure. For what? For whatever is ailing the people. Whatever sickness they have in their heart, to feel that emptiness. And guess what? He got that thing. Did he keep it to himself? No. It became a message for all mankind and jinn. Simple. See it big, keep it simple. Just like that. Moving forward, what do we have? We have hope. Helping other people excel. Helping other people be their best. You know, I want to ask a question. Is anybody here who like to have a better life? I mean, besides me. Come on, our lives are good. I mean, there's people, I mean, we see the things on the TV and all the different places where the people are struggling. Some people in Africa, they got no food, they got no water. How many people are being bombed and putting in all these bad conditions and so on? Our life right now, come on, man. We're living a life right now. This is a good deal. All right? So, let's talk about life. I hope you guys aren't getting bored. I don't want to bore you. Okay, you're cutting me off? He's going to cut me off? What? You give me like this? You're cutting me off now? You're kicking me out? I'm not leaving. I don't care. Okay. I'll be okay. Give me 10 minutes. Okay, guys, you can go 10 minutes?
Okay.
Maybe 15 if you push me. I'll allow you to push me. Don't worry. Okay. Now, okay, let's go. Let's go with life. What's life? What's life?
Living.
Oh, man. Anybody here? You know, the thing is, I'll tell you, sir. The truth of the matter is, going to the jail all the time, I've learned one thing. You don't have to get old to die. You don't have to get old to die. We see people all the time. They're dead. They're living, but they're dead. Inside of them is dead. They've given up hope. They've let fear overwhelm them. They have no desire to win. We're not talking about them surviving. We're talking about them existing, taking up space. That's all they're doing. They don't know how to get more. Islam can show them, but they're not ready to go and make that commitment. They've been confused by all the other stuff out there. We're trying to find a way to bring the clear message to them. I have a project I should have brought to show you. We have a project we're doing in Toronto where we have one brother. His name is Dr. Mustafa Khattab. He's a graduate from Al-Azhar, and he's one of the fine scholars from there. He's over there. He's completed the translation of the Quran in present-day English. Instead of the one that's from 1930, Abdullah Yusuf Ali, that's got thee and thou and whom and all that kind of stuff, he's brought it in English. It's very good. It's called the Clear Quran. We're looking to organize ourselves to build to achieve 5,000 copies of that. He asked me 5,000. I told him we need 50. We want to put it right across the country. We want to put it in every jail and every hospital and every group home, whoever will take it in every library, everywhere. I will take it myself and go. Let's make the message of Islam clear for the people. We came, that's part of our project, but that's another story. Point is, life. You see, if we understand life, it's not just about living. It is about living, but it's living intentionally for excellence. Living intentionally for excellence. Don't make any mistake. We have to be all over this. We have life. Allah's given us life. What do we do with it is all important to what's going to happen next. The things we're going to take to our grave are three. What are they? our wealth, our family, and our deeds. Which one is, two is going away and one is going to stay. Which one?
Deeds.
Come on, man. So we're living a life. We want those deeds where we should be living intentionally for excellence. And that should be our primary objective besides worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But this makes us come now to that point. Now, let's talk about that. You see, let's go back and observe. We want to win. What is the win we want to have over here? The win that I want to have is paradise. Is anybody with me?
Yes.
Paradise. Okay? We have to get over our fear. Who does the fear come from?
Shaitan.
He's not leaving us alone. Not for a little bit. Not for any long period. He's going to be with us doing everything he can, even till you get to the grave. His ability, in effect, is finished when he gets to the grave. Yes? Okay. We have to get over fear. Before we get to the grave. And that means we have to focus. Focus on what? Focus on Sirat al-Mustaqim. Focus on the Dawah. Focus on the fasting. Focus on the wudu. Focus on the coming out to the thing. Focus on coming out to be brothers. You know, one thing I love about Islam is the fellowship. Because people say brotherhood. I say, no. I love the fellowship. Where you, brother? You come from where?
India.
He's come from India, but he's my brother. My family, they want to poison me and my children, but he's my brother. I will send my children to him, they can eat in his house, he can take them and go anywhere he wants, it's no problem. Where are you from, brother?
Syria.
Oh, mashallah. May Allah have mercy on the people of Syria.
Amen.
So, what is that? We're coming out, we took 25,000 in Canada, we took 25,000. We're going to take 25,000 more, and maybe more than that. We're helping, doing what we can. There's other people who did more, but mashallah, that's what we can do. The government before that, they wouldn't take anyone. So we're trying. So for me, those guys who are coming from Syria, I'm working with some of those young people to do what? To help them get their balance. They're coming from bad condition. They're in the refugee camps. They were stealing, lying, cheating, all of that, just to survive. What do you think they bring to Canada? No, they brought the same behavior, that same attitude.
Yeah.
How do you survive? And so it's a different environment. So we're telling them, no, this is not a place you don't have to do that. We have to go slowly, help you step by step, like this. But you have to want to have a better life. So you want to make sure you have hope. So living intentionally for excellence is the best thing. So what is the system? Now, I'm going to get a little bit deeper with you guys, and some of you might not like it, but too bad. What is the system that we have for helping the human being have a better life? Do we have a system or no?
Yes.
What's the system?
Islam.
Oh, mashallah. It's not rocket science, is it? Islam. Now, did I spell that right? Okay, let me spell it again just so you don't make a mistake. Are we good so far?
Yes.
We're good, right? So what is Islam? You see, when it comes right down to it, if we start talking about doing the dawah, what is it we were inviting the people to do? We're inviting the creation back to the worship of the Creator. And the way that they can do this most effectively, the way that they can come now to actually shorten the distance and have a good journey, is that they should do this, just have this one concept. If they have this, then everything opens up nicely. So what is it? Tawheed, yes. And when they get there, they have to know that to do Islam properly, you have to say, I shall love Allah most. Not kind of, sorta, not when you like it, not when it's convenient. I shall love Allah most. Whoa, wait a minute. Well, some people are smiling. Some, you guys get that or no?
Yes.
You see? So, after loving Allah, who do we have to love?
The Prophet.
Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So, what does Islam say about it? Can we check? What does Islam say? I shall love Allah's messenger. I'm done. Not really. Guys, I'm just simply, you see, the thing is, for me, my job is to start a dialogue, to be able to engage people so we can come now to take them to the higher. Is this from the fiqh? Is this from the Quran? Is this from the, I'm not even telling you that. I'm just simply saying, this gets the people to the understanding and appreciation of what's involved with their commitment. And from that now, we can build and help them to understand what more is involved, what other things have to be put in place. And from that, people start getting excited. Because it's laid out now. They got a step process. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 steps. You see, when we start talking about Dawah, just to be clear, we have to include a thing called juice. And I don't mean the juice, box juice. I know the brothers bought some box juice. Jazakallah khairan, Allah barik fiq, shukran jazilin. Right? I'm not talking about that juice. I'm talking about this juice. This juice of Dawah. Because you ought to understand, we should understand what it is we're saying. Exactly. What are we saying? Join us in celebrating excellence. The excellence is found where? The excellence is found in life. By what? Coming now? To submit to Allah and to love Allah and to love His Messenger. We good? You guys good?
Yes.
Okay, next slide. Okay, I'm going to go a little bit quickly. I know it's getting a little bit late. Oh, okay. Now, I want to tell you this. Everything we do counts, right? It counts for good, or it can count for? Who's in charge of that?
Allah.
Take charge of that. Be responsible for that. Let us do the good. And stay away from the other stuff that's like this. Okay? No. See? Oh, I get in trouble. Some people don't like when I put this up. It's a, there is no entitlement. So stop making excuses. There's no entitlement. You're not entitled to nothing. Neither am I. Let's stop making excuses. Let's go ahead and step up our game. Step up our efforts. Commit to a higher level of involvement. Let us organize ourselves better. You know, we were talking today, I was talking with one brother today, and we talk about the fact that one of the things I've seen over here, and you guys can discuss it after, but one of the things I see is that every place I go, I see that they have a thing called a cooperative. And the cooperative is about a big plaza where the people go ahead and they cooperate to be able to organize it, and they put a plaza, and then everybody's paying the rent, and then it becomes something the people benefit from. Isn't it? I said, wow, that's very heavy. That's very nice. Because again, it's not just about one family or one group and something like that, but it's a whole bunch of people coming together who live in the area who get the benefits from that and get dividends and get benefits and subhanAllah. I said, well, how come we don't have one of those things for Dawah? Where's the Dawah cooperative? I'm just talking out loud. I'm just noticing stuff here on the ground. I'm like, wow, that's a great idea. But we should implement that. They're doing it. We can take some of their ideas and make them our ideas, and guess what? They might join us. They might even support us. They might change the whole deal. That's just me. I'm just talking out loud. So there's no excuses. So let's stop making excuses. No, there's no entitlement. Let's stop making excuses. Next slide, please. Okay. What do you say? Oh gosh, here we go. This is good stuff. Okay, just populate it right out. You see, my obligation is to help people with three things. Yeah, all the way. All the way. Yeah, okay. Oh, wait. It didn't go back. Go back and do it again. What is it? ABCs, attitude. Okay, it's not showing everything. The ABCs are this: attitude, belief, and commitment. Attitude, belief, and commitment. That's okay. Just go. That's okay. Go for it.
We're good.
Yeah, this is okay. Attitude, belief, and commitment. Maybe the letters are too big. It changed it when it goes on your thing. It changes the font. Okay, so it's okay. Just go forward.
Forward.
Yes. Okay. So questions are to answer. Okay. So the question is this: do you believe that you have the potential within yourself to do more, be more, and have more? Yes or yes.
Yes.
Okay. Would you like to realize that potential now, or remain as you are? Yes, let's realize it. Okay. Then, are you ready to take action now and move forward and achieve your dreams?
Yes.
Good. Wonderful. Let's go. See, because now we have to know the difference between this. What do you see?
Good.
Do you?
Yeah, good.
Oh, wait, no. Hold on. Look closer.
Good is there even.
Uh-huh.
I see good.
Oh, good. MashaAllah. It's always good to see good.
Yes.
I think it's good that you see good, but when we see good, it's good.
I see good.
Right? But there's more than that here.
I see even within the good.
You see evil within the good.
Yes. Manist.
You see?
Good, then I saw evil. I can't see
Manist. Good anymore.
Yeah. Now we got him confused. Okay, give him 2 samosa and let you go. You can keep your A, don't worry. So, what do we have? I mean, come on, let's be honest. If we don't know the difference between this, how can we help other people? If we can help people understand the difference between good, G-O-O-D, and evil, E-V-I-L. This is our job. This is the dawah. What they're doing is evil. Let's not make any mistake. They're doing the worst thing. That if they continue to do this thing, they go to the fire and they don't come out. They're making shirk with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They're coming out to break all their conditions of what Allah's put them on the fitrah. Everything is finished. They're finishing it by doing what? They're doing the evil. We have to invite them to good. But sometimes it gets mixed up like this. We get mixed up like this. How do we help them to come out if we don't know the difference between this and this? Next slide, please. See, this for me is one of the crucial things. It's one of the really beautiful things that we have, that we've developed. This is called the balance wheel. And I want you to pay close attention to this. Anyone who's taking any use, everyone should take pictures of this. You guys never seen this before. Wallah. You need to see this. You need to remember this. It's going to be in the video and all that kind of stuff. But okay, I'm leaving also the presentation with the brother, Mubin. That's, you know, you understand. We want you to understand this, guys. Wallah, you need to understand this. You see, if you notice in the middle, what do we have? We have values. What is around the values? You go now to the left and you go personal, health, recreation, family, friends, community, career, financial, household, and spiritual. If you notice on the outside, you also see over here where you see mission and legacy. What is the mission we're on? We're on a mission for dawah. Are we on a mission for dawah or not?
Yes.
If we're on a mission for dawah, then we're going to have to understand that we're not going to get the whole job done. We're going to have to leave a legacy. We're going to have to leave steps in the sand that people can follow. We're pioneering stuff that's coming now to be online. We have all these conditions of connecting people in all these different ways and bringing it to them in very special and very effective means. But we got to know that we're not going to finish the job. The Prophet ﷺ, he completed his task. We're not like him. We should strive to be, but we're going to come down to be a lower level than that. But each one of us is supposed to commit. You know, I'll tell you. Okay, I want to do some math here. Okay. If I say to you 1 plus 1 equals? I love your attitude, man. I knew it. I knew you were catching up, bro. That's all. Mashallah. 1 plus 1 equals? 2. Right? That's in general. That's what everybody else believes. You see, Allah's given us a circumstance to be able to make 1 plus 1 equal more than that. It doesn't equal 2. And we own that condition, that in condition of making the 1 plus 1 more than 2. How do we get that? By a thing called barakah, but that barakah is based on our synergy. Let me tell you about synergy. I love this word. What is synergy? Synergy is the condition where the sum of the parts is greater than the whole. The 1 plus 1 has to be greater than 2, has to be 3. Or it could be 5, could be 50, could be 1,000, could be 1,000,000. There's no end. What does it mean? When we say synergy, what is it? You do your best. He does his best. He does his best. He does his best. He does his best. Everybody does their best. I do my best. And we create a result that's greater than any one of us can do. You try by yourself, you can't do it. Him, these two guys, they can't do it. Him, he try, I try, all of us, we half of the room tries, we can't do it. All together, man, we max it out. But that's where we go from me to we. That's where we make it happen. We have our intention, we have our conditions, we have our guidance, we have our steps of understanding, they have the inspiration, we have the desire to get there, subhanAllah. After that, it's almost like a done deal. Really and truly, it's almost like a done deal. But not if we don't pull it together. Not if we don't go from me to we. Instead of being individuals, we come together collectively and we make the effort. And I come here as a small group of people from Canada. We were gone to Qatar to be able to organize some things and talk about the Canadian situation with the government and the Islamic organizations and so on like that. There's a lot of room for growth. We need to have a better communication system, a lot of less misunderstanding and so on and so forth. But we came here with that intention to be able to do that over there and over here. Why? Because we believe in it. So people, I'm coming here to tell you that me, I want in Canada, I want the Muslims and the people of Canada to be safe. But some people have gone to extremes. We've dealt with those guys and those guys are in jail. Guess who gets to deal with them? I'm going to raise my hand and you should understand that. This is one of the things we deal with. So I don't just want safety for over here. We have people who want to go from over here, over there, to be able to come over here and do bad things. We don't accept that. At all. I don't accept it. You can't hurt my brothers. You can't come to damage our synergy and the love we have for each other, our fellowship. No. Will I fight you? Absolutely. Do I know how to fight? You bet. If you're coming to fight me, bring a lunch. You're going to be here for a minute. It's not so easy. But the whole point is, love, peace. Peace is the first option. But the reality is, we got to get busy. We have potential. We have unbelievable condition of being on an amazing mission. Amazing mission. To be able to do so much good. But not if we don't actually capture it, organize it, and make it work. So, okay, hold on one second. I want to do one thing. Okay, I have my people bugging me back home. Okay, you got to take a picture. Okay, what did I do with my phone? I had it. Okay, oh, I got it. Okay, wait. Just bear with me one second. No, it's okay. I'm going to, okay, see. I do that. Okay, here we go. Yes, just take a picture for me, please. I guess this. I love this. See?
I don't
think, Sherman.
Okay.
Is it good? Okay, good. I can send them back and I can prove I did something. Okay? Yes. Oh, yes. Okay. Now, I know. Are you still around? What are you doing, man? Come on, man. Yeah. Oh, now he's going to kick me out of the country. You're taking my visa too? Passport? You want my passport? Yeah, just take it, man. Just, subhanAllah. Okay. Okay. I'm leaving it up to you. Don't listen to the tall, dark, handsome fellow over there, okay? All right? I'm leaving it up to you. I can finish. I like to finish. Really want to leave everything. For me, I don't believe that when you step on the field, you're talking soccer, baseball, basketball, I don't care what it is, you don't leave your best game in the locker room. You came to the field for a reason. Me, I'm almost done. You guys with me? Let's do this. Next slide. You guys have any questions about this? No? Okay, we'll go over it again later. Go, brother. See, now we get to the real kiss. This is a sweet spot for me. You see, this is the one thing that we don't do. I think you should take pictures of every slide. The next, I don't know, 5 or 6 slides, you should be taking pictures of every slide. Trust me when I tell you. Okay? The people who are coming now to be the most effective in controlling things in our society and the places where we are in the world are the people who have written goals. If you're sitting here and you don't have written goals, today that's the end of that. That's supposed to be the end of that. Finish. You're supposed to have, by even you go to sleep, or at least by you wake up tomorrow, you have 10 goals. And if you can, do 20. It's going to be better for you. And I'm going to show you why in a minute, because you're going to go through a process. And that process is a very effective process for achieving goals. Not setting goals only, but also achieving goals. Next slide, please. Once you get down to 10, then I want you to do this. I want you to put it down to 5. I want you to take from the 10, 5 goals. When you get from the 10 down to 5, then I want you to do this. I want you to do the 1, 3, 5. I want you to put down 1 goal from the 5. 3 reasons why it's important, and 5 action steps you know you have to take with target dates. You see this? Target dates of when you're going to start and when you're going to achieve that goal. You're going to take guesstimates. Don't worry about that. You make a guesstimate, big deal. If you have to expand it, okay. If it goes faster, no problem. But you set down target dates of when you're going to start and when you're going to achieve that goal. Understand this. A goal is created 3 times. First, as a mental picture of something you want to be, have, or do. Second, when written down to add clarity and dimension. And third, when you take action towards its achievement. If you do not take any action towards this achievement, you do not commit to the process of actually stepping up and doing what it takes, guess what happens? I'll give you three guesses and the first two don't count. Nothing. You get nothing. You get nothing. And they say, oh, that stuff didn't work. Oh, the stuff works fine. You didn't do it. Don't say it didn't. If you didn't do it, don't say you did it. If you didn't do it, don't say it doesn't work. It works. But if you don't have the confidence, if fear is going to be your friend, you put yourself out. It's got nothing to do with the training. You see? Next slide. See, for me, I take from my clients and I take from the people who work with me sincerely and committedly, I take from them a contract. I mean, everybody gets a contract. You don't get to work with me without a contract. Just letting you know how it is. So who's the contract with?
Yourself.
You contract with yourself. You see, if you get up every day and you're lying to yourself, and you're cheating yourself, and you're holding back from yourself, and you're being stingy with yourself, no, I'm telling you, be generous with yourself. Give all you got while you can. It's called life. Where you're living intentionally for excellence. You're not living for excellence? What are you really doing? Question yourself. But you need to make this contract. You need to put the goal that you've decided you're going to take from the 1, 3, 5. You need to put it in here. Read this. I hereby commit to achieving this goal. I will plan thoroughly, act boldly, and be accountable for my actions. I will focus on the results and enforce the values of discipline, character, and perseverance until success is achieved. I will make sure that everything I think, say, and do counts. I will begin today to achieve this. You date it, you sign it. You date it, you sign it, and you get busy. And I'm not talking wishy-washy, I'm talking absolutely. You make something happen. You take one step towards, and you know what? The biggest problem is, people think they have to go and now they have to be perfect. You don't have to be perfect. Matter of fact, I will tell you this. Really, if you want to know, what you need to do is you don't need to get it right, you just need to get it going. Just start. And if you can, really if you can, think about it and improving yourself 1 degree per day. 365 days, how many degrees you got? 365. What happens in 2 years? You just improve. You just improve. 1 degree. Not, I mean, just 1 degree. What can I do today that's make you better? What can I do today to make a better commitment? What can I do to, like this? How can I work with others? And so on and so forth like that. We need commitment. Next. Does this make sense to anyone? Am I talking too fast?
Yes.
I hope you guys aren't getting bored. Okay? Okay. Nobody does this. But the people who are in charge do this. What do they do? They do a thing called an after-action review. What is that? You see, yes, you have to come now to understand that when you set a goal, what you have to do is you have to review it. Within 2 weeks to 30 days, you have to review your goal. And you're going to find that you're going to be in one of three spots. You're going to be on point. No, you're either going to be ahead of what you're striving for. You're going to be exactly where you are, do you want it to be, or you're going to be behind. If you're behind, what do? You have to review and say, okay, I wanted to be here. I have my target date. How come I'm not there? What else do I need to do? You put it in here. What is the outcome? What is the goal? The strengths and weaknesses. You review the thing. You have a template here. You don't have to use this page. Just use the template, the conscious template of putting these things into order. You write them out and you say, okay, this is what I'm going to do. And guess what? You know what the most important thing you could do here? You know what I would tell you is a real crucial thing that make it go from your head to your heart? You share it with others. Because you know what it is now. And when you share it, sharing is caring. And I'm telling you, we bring more value to each other by helping people achieve their goals. And we're going to make dua. People say, yeah, make dua. Yes, brother, mashallah. Yes, make dua. Don't forget your dua. But also, put in some work. Next slide, please. Okay, this is kind of funny, and I'm not trying to be funny, but this is one of the most important things I could share with you. Before you begin the whole goal setting process, I want you to do this. This is called the victory list of your accomplishments. These are things, okay, 25 things that you've already done. You graduate from school. A bunch of you put up your hands behind that, so I know you're doing okay. Right? Some of you got married. Uh-huh. Some of you got kids. Yeah, I got it. Yeah, huh? Right? Some of you fasted. Ramadan, if you fasted. Yeah? Anybody made Hajj besides me? I mean, go ahead. You know, whatever you did. You maybe give somebody Shahada. Mashallah, put it on your list. Did you give some sadaqah? Put it on your list. Did you remove something from the roadway that hurt people? Did you help people? Did you open the door for the elderly and so on? Whatever, it doesn't matter what you want. Put it on your list. Put at least 25 things on your list before you even start with your goals. Ask me why.
Why?
Because we want to create for you the circumstance of being very positive in your mind, a positive mindset. And if you already done things and you can record those things and you start to realize the feelings you had when you did those things, guess what happens? Writing a list of 20 goals is no big deal. You start thinking, wow, okay, boom. But it comes from the things you already done. But you know what else happens too? Is you start to look at the situation of what you've been able to achieve from the things that you've already achieved. There were guys I'm asking, well, did you ever think that you were going to quit? You say, yeah, I was going to quit. You know, they're school. They're going to school. You know, it's hard. But guess what? They got through. So now you understand what it is, the value of not quitting. When you got through, you say, oh man, oh, Allahu Akbar. Isn't it?
Yes.
You see? So how many things you did like that? If you start to think about that, before you start writing your goals, you're going to have a list of more than 20 goals. You should have a list. You could have a list of 100 goals. Doesn't matter what the number is, but at least 20. Because you want a goal pool. And when you achieve one goal, you go back to your goal pool until they're all achieved. And then when you finish the 20, guess what you do? Put 20 more. But start here. Write out your list. Because I guarantee you, if you can achieve 20 goals, this list right here is very simple. You only have to add 5. Do the math. It's just so simple. And you just repeat that, and you repeat that. And you know who I want you to teach this to? If I could get you to do anything, you know what I would want you to teach this to? You know who I think deserves this more than anyone else? It's our children. Give it the gift to them. Hadiyah, give it. It's not me. I said, hey. This brother got me wired up. I don't even know what's going on. He's got this ringing, that ringing. I started buzzing, man. Did my nose turn red? I don't know. Anyway, so any questions? Next slide, please. See, you got to make a decision. What's the decision? I know. This is success. Yeah, baby, just take it easy.
What I do is,
if
people get cold and want to go, we can eat and come back.
Okay. I'm almost finished. I need 2 minutes. 2 minutes. You see, you got to make a decision. It doesn't take much strength to do things, but it requires great strength to decide what to do. Okay? You good? No? Okay, father. Who got you? I got your back, player. Don't worry. Okay, next slide, please. Okay? What are you talking about? You see, we're talking about doing what? Going from where you are now to where you want to be. You have to make a quantum leap. And you have to pay your price for your own success. You like this, I know you do. Okay, next. Okay? Ah, baby. You see, if we understand the circumstance of synergy, remember I said synergy?
Yes.
You see, synergy is like this thing right in the middle, this helix right in the middle here. You understand that? You see, what does synergy take? It takes your will, your niyyah. It takes your knowledge, the ilm, and it takes your risk. Oh, baby. Oh, man. You see, I'm hoping when I come back, you guys will have translated all of this into Arabic and put it up there. And, you know what I mean? Take it to the people and say, hey, look, guess what? Guess what we have now? We have some empowerment training. You see, we don't do enough of this as Muslims. We don't. I just don't see people doing it. I love to do this because we want people to feel empowered that you can take action and you can do it together. And collectively, we can achieve big things, nice things. But we have to find a way to close the distance. Next slide. Does anybody get this? You guys get this? It's a nexus of synergy. It's all those three can come together with our intention to work together. It changes everything, but okay. Go ahead. Okay. Oh. Okay, yeah, that's okay. This is good. Okay, I think we're coming up to the end. Okay, this is the story of everybody, somebody, nobody, and anybody. Once there was an important job to be done, and everybody was just so sure that somebody would do it. Now, anyone could have done it, but nobody did it. When nobody did it, everybody got angry, because they were sure that it was somebody's job. Everybody thought that somebody would do it, but they did not realize that nobody would do it. So it ended up that everybody blamed somebody for something that anybody could have done, but nobody did. How many times do we see that? You guys are laughing because you know exactly what I'm talking about. I didn't make this up, but I'm giving it to you, okay? Come on. How many times we saw this? How many times? SubhanAllah. Okay, brother, was it my fault? No, it's not my fault. Hold on. Let's see. What am I doing here? What am I doing? Anybody? So that's one finger pointing out, deflecting responsibility. Okay, it's supposed to be coming to me and say, okay, well, what did I do that I should have done? If he didn't do it, how come I should have stepped up? Why not just take it like that? Three finger, one to three. One finger pointing out, three fingers pointing back. He's not doing it. Okay, let me see what I can do. Next. Okay. 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 The most important thing is how you see yourself. And I know nobody in here is put together. There's no pussycats in here, man. There's no pussycats in here. There's lions of the desert here. Hey, they call me the Canadian Bedouin. So I got it. Next, please. Oh, okay. Let me finish off with this. You're gonna have to give me a bear with me here. I hate to live without showing you this. Okay? Now, don't change that slide. Okay, can you guys read that? Okay. Yeah, Muhammad, I'll finish soon, boy. I'll finish soon, brother. Just, okay. Okay, that's not working. Okay, let me see. Come on.
Can I help you?
I don't know, can you? I just want to get some space here. This is not working so good. That's okay. I got it. This is good. Okay, let me try to dry this off. Okay, watch this. Did you read this? I'm giving you two choices. Two. How many choices?
Two.
I give you a penny. I don't know what you call it over here, but we call it a penny. Fils. It's one, is what? Fils?
Fils.
Okay, I'm giving you one fils. Okay? You get one fils, or you can get $1 million. But the fil has got special condition. What's the condition? It doubles every day for 31 days. How many days? 31. 32. No, because some people get carried away, man. No, brother, just let it double. No. 31 days. I'm going to write that down so nobody gets confused. 31 days. Now, here's the deal. Okay? We have over here what's called the lifeline. And over here we have a timeline. Are you with me?
Yeah.
Okay? Can we all agree that going up is positive and going down is negative?
Yeah.
Generally speaking. Okay? Now, in the case with the penny or the $1 million, each one is going to go down this timeline. It's going to go down this timeline in this fashion. Like this. You with me?
Yes.
Okay. How many people, now decision time. How many people here, given that you have the penny, which doubles every day for 31 days, and you have the $1 million that you can take right now, all-purpose cash, shop till you drop. We put $1 million down here for each one of you. It's got your name on it. You can take it from here. You can go out the door and you can spend it on whatever you want. How many people here will walk over here and take the $1 million? Two, three, no, come on, be honest, guys, come on, anybody? No more being, you with me? What about you?
I'll take the penny.
You take the penny? What about you?
I take penny.
Take penny? I'm taking penny. Who's taking penny? Oh, we are the million and the penny. Man, you're a negotiator, brother. Okay, you have me at salams, okay? Assalamu alaikum. Yes, take the million and the penny. Okay, no. Okay, so, how many people take the penny? Seriously. You see, you're thinking about it now. You're thinking about it. And that's exactly what this whole process is designed to do, to help you think. This training is to help people just do one thing, to help them think. Dawah is about doing what? Helping people think. This is not rocket science, guys. This is a very simple process by which we have been invited by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the big table to say, behind the prophets, you can make your effort. But it's very much like this example. The people are being offered penny, doubles every day for 31 days, and $1 million. They're coming to the table saying, I'm out of here. They got their money and gone. And guess what? But there's something wrong. You see, let's look at the million. Okay? All you guys, you'll get a second chance at that, taking what you want here. Okay? Let's look at the million. The million goes like this, and then it goes like this. Here's your $1 million. $1 million. What happened?
That's a maximum.
Well, what happened? You got $1 million over here. You got it over here. What happened to the million? You start spending. What do you spend it on? Brother, you got $1 million. What would you spend it on? First thing, one thing, right now.
Just try to spend some wealth.
Fair enough. How about you? What would you spend it on?
I'll buy some land.
You buy some land. How about you, brother?
Education, health.
Education, health. Okay. Who would you?
I take the bank.
No, no. But if you had $1 million, what would you buy?
Real estate.
Okay, how about you?
A luxury car.
Luxury car, mashallah. How about you, Sheikh?
Sadaqah.
Ah, mashallah, I like your attitude. Mashallah. No, because again, all of us will buy something. Okay, $1 million is not just going to sit there and we're going to look at it. Oh my gosh, mashallah. No, no, we're going out, we're going spending, we're going shopping. Okay, we are going shopping. Okay, but this is what happens to the million. The million comes now to actually go down. Whether you're buying real estate or whether you're doing investments or whether you're doing education or whether you're buying diamonds or whether you're buying gold or whether you're taking trips or whether you're giving sadaqah, in any case, the million goes down. It's got to. Now, some people say, but I'm doing investments, maybe it'll come back. But investments aren't like what they used to be. They used to be that you could have some kind of a commitment, solid. People are going to make commitment, you're going to get something back. These days, people putting out their money, they're losing it so fast. Huh? Okay, so let's talk about that. Let's talk about that penny. You see, that penny is coming now along this line. And then after 31 days, how many days?
31.
It's got to go up. It's got to. It's just a process of compounding. So that penny, after 31 days of compounding, becomes $10.7 million. Do the math. I know you maybe not believe me. I know people tell me already, rather, no, come on. You're exaggerating. Come on, man. You're going too far. No, no, do the math yourself.
31 days.
First day is one.
Exponential.
Then it's coming out two. Exponential. Then it's coming four. 8, 16, 32, 64, like this, 256, it's going like that. If you go all the way to 31 days, you'll find more than 10.7 million plus. Make no mistake. Now, let's break it down. Me, I call this breaking it down like a fraction. You see the people who come now to take, and okay, hold on, knowing that it's going to be 10 million as opposed to 1 million, who would now change their mind and take that penny? Huh? No, no, there's some people saying, I don't know, man. I like having the money in my pocket.
You see? You see?
You see? And so what is that? Really what it comes down to, it comes down to this condition of what? Immediate gratification. Immediate gratification. Let me put it to you another way. Adunya sijinu mukmin wa janatul kafir. Ooh. Ooh. Immediate gratification. You see, this over here, taking the million, simple mistake. Simple mistake. Okay? Big mistake. Compared, you can get 10. If you can go 31 days, you can get 10 times that. But this is a simple mistake. This is a simple error in judgment. This is a simple discipline. This is related to Islam and bringing people to Islam and doing the dawah of Islam. And this comes now to be the thing that becomes a simple discipline. But it's also about delayed gratification. We trust in Allah. We put our tawakkul on Allah. And from that, we get so much more. But we also leave an example for others. That when they see us and they understand what we're doing, they say, okay, I want to be like you. I want to have like you. I want to learn like you. How do I come now to be with this program? How do I get on that path? How do I get that focus? How do I get that win? For me, I'm just showing you. For me, it's real simple. This is what I do. And if you notice, I'm not going into my PDA and my phone and trying to figure out all of this stuff. We're doing this for years. Years. We can't get people to listen. I'm happy you're taping it now so you can show others that are not going to be here. And if you remember me, remember that I told you and I shared with you from my heart what we're using, what we put together with sincerity, with commitment, with the full intention of pleasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to be able to use it for the benefit of the people who are not Muslim, and especially the people who are. They could feel inspired to be able to get more done. Step up your game, work harder. Me, I'm a tireless worker, man. I love this stuff. Me, I could have been in my grave over 30 years ago. I wasn't Allah's plan. We plan, Allah plans, and Allah's the best planner. So, I'm going to stop here. I don't want to make Muhammad mad. He's still got to drive me home. I want to thank you for your time. I want to thank you for your attention. I want to thank you for your generosity of being here today. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept it from us. Ya hamak Allah, ya habibi, fadda ya. Ya sheikh, fadda. Inshallah. Right? I'm very happy to be here. I can't even begin to tell you. For me, I'm thinking about how I could come and live here, except I have this commitment to go and do some things back home. If not, I would love to come and live here. And I don't say that. People offered me to come and live there. I went to UK. I got off the plane. I went and did the Jummah Qudwa. They said, brother, can you come and live here? I said, no, man. This is not Kuwait. But not anyway. I love it here. I love the people here. I love you guys. I'm going to leave here soon, inshallah. And when I leave here, I will take you with me. Here. Huh? And I'm going to stay here with you too. Guess where you can find me? Here. No,
put me in the front.
Yes, you're in the front. Don't worry, you're in the front seat. These are the $1 million chairs here, by the way. Inshallah. Now, I would like to have each one of you, your contact information, if I don't have it already. Okay? I will go back to Canada. I send out amazing things. I get stuff from people all over the world on WhatsApp. And if you give me your contact, I will send you from those things. I make a list of people. I send it out. And we get some very good things, very interesting things. Some of it controversial, but not too bad. And we don't have bad manners behind our efforts. So, inshallah. If I've said anything that is wrong or incorrect, then truly that is with me and with Shaitan. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive me. And I ask your forgiveness if I've offended anyone. And if I said anything that was good and beneficial to you, truly that came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His mercy. And we should all praise Allah and thank Him for that benefit that He's given us. And I'm very thankful for the opportunity to be here with you today.
شكرا يا ربي شكرا هديت قلبي شكرا نورت دربي شكرا شكرا يا